public health. Because I know I don't have health care. And I know I'm living kind of rough right now. I know I don't look like it. I'm kind of fly right now, but, you know, I'm living rough.
Public health makes me think about the general well-being of people.
I thought public health was that you don't have to pay for it, and private was you have to pay for it. As simple as that.
What does public health mean to you?
Free condoms.
Free condoms.
I think of agencies that are kind of out there working for the whole public.
Confusion.
Right, just think of personal health and making sure that you take good care of yourself and eat well and exercise.
Don't get sick and die.
Public health, it's not only physical, also mental.
I love them.
Public health means a lot of things to a lot of people. Hi, I'm Howard Frumkin, Dean of the School of Public Health at the University of Washington. To me, public health means the sum total of all that we do to create conditions in which people can be safe and healthy. Public health includes studying conditions from diabetes to HIV, from mental illness to injuries, understanding why they occur, how to treat them, and how to prevent them. It means studying the way healthcare systems work and devising ways to make them more effective and more cost-effective. It means creating environmental conditions in which people can be healthy: clean air, clean water, safe food, walkable neighborhoods. And it means preparing for public health emergencies, ranging from disease outbreaks to natural disasters. I could go on and on. I probably already have. But instead, let me introduce you to the men and women at the University of Washington School of Public Health so that they can tell you in their own words about what they do to protect public health.
The way my research that I'm currently working on affects public health is to try to discover why certain people get certain tests for cancer, why they don't get certain tests, and how that affects the care that they get and eventually their outcome, their quality of life, and maybe even how long they live.
I'm currently doing a research looking at breast cancer knowledge, beliefs, and personal practices among female nurses and midwives in Ghana. And in the past couple years, breast cancer has become a huge burden in low and middle income countries, and this was not the case in the past. So now we are trying to develop tools to help equip the healthcare workforce in these low and middle income countries to be able to improve breast health outcomes for these women.
I study the determinants of diabetes in American Indian communities among 13 reservations in North Dakota, South Dakota, Oklahoma, and Arizona. I'm particularly interested in the effect of physical activity on diabetes development, as well as the effect of diet on diabetes development. The American Indian communities I work with have extremely high intakes of SPAM, and we've shown that lowering intake of SPAM may potentially reduce diabetes risk significantly.
So the work in the Department of Biostatistics broadly impacts all of public health. Lots of studies of our clinical trials, for example, or the spread of epidemics involve the collection of data and the interpretation of data. So people in the Department of Biostatistics develop methodology and apply those methods to interpret data.
We're doing two projects that are really important for public health. One of those is a project in auto body workers to try and find the best gloves and coverall materials that they wear. And the other is a project to measure community air pollution in Duwamish Valley and South Tacoma.
The center that I work for focuses on strengthening health systems in countries all over the world. And I particularly work on a project in the Caribbean region. We focus on training and education of healthcare providers, mostly in HIV and tuberculosis. And we also focus on providing technical assistance to ministries of health and universities, national AIDS program, national tuberculosis program, that type of thing.
We are doing the Seattle Obesity Study, which has to do with disparities in health and body weight among Seattle communities. So this is a project where we look at where people live, where they shop, what foods they buy, how much they spend, and what their health and weight are as a result of that. So it's all about social disparities and making sure that everyone in Seattle, King County, does have access to affordable, healthy foods.
You've just had a small taste of the great work in public health being done by the men and women at the University of Washington School of Public Health. You've learned a few things about public health. For one thing, we're science-based and we're values-based. The science base of public health ranges from epidemiology to biostatistics, from genetics to toxicology, from civil and environmental engineering to communication science. But the values-based reflects a shared commitment that all people deserve the right to a safe and healthy life. You've also learned that we in public health are practical and we're idealistic. The idealism reflects a commitment that the world ought to be a better place and that we can help make it that way. But the practical side of public health reflects a recognition that good intentions are not enough. We need programs that work. That means testing them, modifying them, and collecting metrics until we know they're effective. Public health is local, and it's also global. The local part of public health reflects the work that we do in our own communities to make them safer and healthier for the people who live there. But we also know that we have a commitment to the entire world, and the work that we do reaches the far corners of the globe. As we at the University of Washington prepare to train and equip the next generation of public health leaders, we hope you'll join us. Thanks.